Dear students, in this class we will discuss most important concept, that is applications of ampere circuit law. We have already discussed the ampere circuit law in my last class. Okay, now derive the magnetic field due to solenoid. What do you mean by solenoid? Look at this figure. Okay, look at this figure. A solenoid is a spring type of conductor coil, a spring type of conductor coil, or it is nothing but it is look like a cylindrical coil, a wire acting on a magnet when carrying electric current, when it is carrying the electric current, we can call it as a solenoid. It's nothing but a look like a spring only. Okay, we have to find the magnetic field when the electric current is passed through in this coil. Okay, in this coil here, the spring type coil, that is the different turns are not touching each other. We can look at this spring here. Each coil, each turns not touching each other, and the current pass through them, and the current pass through them. Suppose we just consider any one turn. Suppose here there is a n number of turns in this spring. Just assume that only one circle, only one turn, that is nothing but a circle. If the current will pass through that circle, there will be a magnetic field at the center. Okay, if the current is passed through one turn only, okay, when it is passed through in current, there will be a magnetic field at the center of the circle. When it comes out the circle, it will go this this direction. Okay, you can see here, when it will come here, when the current is moving this direction here, okay, when here the magnetic field come out here and go this direction. Okay, go this direction. Now after passing through the certain distance, it will come in the again reverse direction here. Okay, I will show here. When the current is passing through in this direction here, magnetic field will be generating, it will move and it will go and it will come this direction. Okay, in this direction. Suppose if you make a second coil, again second coil, same second coil, what will happen here? That will current will come this direction, magnetic field will be generating at the center. Okay, generating at the center, and it will move to the magnetic field will be generating in this direction, and it will come this direction. Suppose another coil, again magnetic field will be generating, it will go this direction and it will come here this direction. Again another coil, same magnetic field will be generating and it will go this direction. Okay, suppose thus what will happen here, the magnetic field, the field goes straight inside the coil now here. Okay, field goes straight inside the coil because at the center it has to be straight. Now we consider all the spring of magnetic field goes straight. Okay, straight. What will happen here? The magnetic field exactly it will develop the at the center. Okay, so what is the shape of the magnetic field along the axis? Okay, what is the shape of the magnetic field along this axis? Is straight inside the solenoid. Okay, straight inside the solenoid. What will happen here? Suppose here there is a only one coil, only one coil. If it is only one coil, magnetic field will be generating here and it will move come again this direction. Okay, but another coil, second coil, third coil, fourth coil, fifth coil, up to the end of the coil, what will happen? What is the direction of the magnetic field? Will be always will be straight, straight. Okay, okay, this is the magnetic field, it will be developed in this direction, straight direction. Now why it is straight inside why it is straight, magnetic direction is straight inside that solenoid? Because there is no space and there is no time, so it won't turn immediately after the second turn. There is another turn, close one, so it will be go straight. Okay, because there is no space here, there is no space and there is no time. Then because of that reason it won't turn, because that reason it won't turn, due to that reason it will come straight and it will move this direction. Okay, this is the coil. When an electric field is passed through that coil, magnetic field will generate in center, it will move and it will come here. Another coil, go to the another coil, again it will come this direction and it will move this direction. Okay, why it is moving that direction, why it is straight, why it is straight inside that, because there is no space in between the both the coil and there is no time also. Because of that reason it won't turn immediately. After second turn there is another turn. Okay, because of that reason this the one turn and another turn, it will be very close to each other here. Okay, very close to each other here, so that the outside, so that outside the magnetic field will be spread out. Okay, when it will come out it will be spread out, but inside, inside the solenoid is always straight. Now there is a magnetic field is center, as I discussed in earlier figure. Okay, there is a magnetic field is center, all magnetic fields are same direction, as I told you that all the magnetic field are same direction, and the magnitude of that magnetic field is also same, magnitude also same. This is the uniform magnetic field, this is a uniform magnetic field. Okay, suppose, let us suppose has a straight line, as I told that this is a straight line, magnetic field is straight line. Suppose just assume that the strength of the magnetic field is B. Okay, strength of the magnetic field is B. Now we want to find out how much will be strength B. Okay, we have to find out the what is the strength of the magnetic field inside the solenoid. This is the main derivation. Okay, this is the spring, as I told that, I would repeat once again here, what do you mean by solenoid? Solenoid is a spring type conductor coil. What we have to find the, when the electric current is passed through inside this coil, how much magnetic field will be generating, we have to find out that one. Okay, now we will find out the magnetic field, what is the value of B, in using Ampere's circuital law. Okay, we just assume that Ampere loops, we just assume that there is a one loop, that is I'm taking inside, this is the coil, this is the figure, the loop, considering this is the PQRS is the loop. Okay, PQRS is the loop. Consider a rectangular, this is a rectangular. Okay, it is in the form of rectangular, PQRS, with suppose the length of the solenoid is L. Okay, the length is L, then side PQ and SR. Okay, the side PQ and SR both are parallel here, this figure, second figure, PQ and SR is the parallel here, where PS and QR is the perpendicular. PS we can see here, PS, okay, and RQ, there is a perpendicular, both are perpendicular. Now the magnetic field B is uniform. Okay, the magnetic field is B is uniform, and the direction along the axis, the magnetic field is, as I told that magnetic field B is uniform and has a direction along the axis, so that angle theta is zero. Okay, as I told that magnetic field is uniform, has a direction along the axis, as I told the direction along the axis, I will show it here. Okay, this direction, in this direction the magnetic field along this axis, that is theta angle is zero. So this one side of the loop and magnetic field both are having the same direction. Okay, here how the magnetic field will be developing, as I told in solenoid, the magnetic field will be developing here. Okay, magnetic field direction will be here, that here the side of the loop and magnetic field both having the same direction. So every point is magnetic field is the zero. That is a symmetric system in symmetry inside only. Okay, now just consider a closed rectangular path, that is PQRS. That is, this is the PQ. Just consider PQRS. The sides PQ and RS are parallel to the axis of the solenoid. Okay, now where PS and Q are perpendicular to it, therefore as per the Ampere circuit law, what is the Ampere circuit law? That is line that is over surface integral, that is BDL is equal to cos theta. BDL is equal to cos theta. But this we have considered the rectangular here. Okay, this is the rectangular. We have to assume, we have to apply for the Ampere's circuit law here. As per the Ampere circuit law, that is BDL is equal to BDL cos theta, as we already know this. Okay, according to Ampere circuit law, BDL line integral, that is B vector B into DL is equal to, because this is complete rectangular circle, we have to apply here. That is integral of P to Q, integral of P to Q BDL into cos theta, plus again Q to R. What is the distance Q to R? Integral of Q to R, integral of Q to R B into DL, plus integral of R to S B into DL, plus integral of S to P B into DL. But BDL vector B into vector DL is equal to BDL cos theta, as we already know that. Okay, BDL, integral of BDL is equal to line integral BDL cos theta. But here the cos theta vector P to Q here, vector P to Q, the angle is zero. Angle is zero. Now just substituting the BDL cos theta is nothing but a zero, plus integral of Q to R, that angle is 90 degree, and integral of R to S, the BDL cos theta is 180 degree, and integral S to P B into DL angle is theta is 90. Nothing but a here cos 0 is equal to 1, cos 0 is equal to 1, and cos 0 1, this is a cos 90 is equal to 0, and cos 90, this is also 0, and cos 180, this is also 0. Remaining only, what is the remaining thing? That is BDL 1, integral of BDL cos theta. Cos theta is cos 0 is equal to 1. That is, just take the outside, B is the outside, that is B is equal to, take outside B and P to Q. Now, as we know that solenoid, it is a spring type coil, that magnetic field is always depend upon the length and number of turns when a current is applied on that coil. Okay, just assume that the length, coil length is L, and there is a n number of terms here. Okay, this is n number of terms here. The capital N is the total number of terms. Capital N is the total, this is overall total number of how many terms is there, that is a capital N. Capital N is equal to small n is the number of terms, and L is the length. Number of terms is always depend upon the total number of length. Okay, whatever it may be, either suppose the half meter there is a 100 turns, or half meter there is a 200 turns, that is depend upon length. but total or density of the terms is capital N. N is the total number of terms, comma small n is the number of terms of the coil per meter. Okay, L is the length of the coil. But we have to know that how much the current passing through the loop, this spring or solenoid, how much the current passing through the loop means, that is depend upon the, suppose one turn current is I, okay, one turn current is I, and I is number of terms N and length and applied current, okay, capital is applied current. But I is the current at one turn, but how many the total turns are there, N into IL. Now we apply the Ampere circuital law, that is integral of B vector B into dl is equal to mu naught into I, that is standard formula for Ampere's law, that B dl is equal to, we have already defined, that is the BL is equal to mu naught I is equal to mu naught into N L I. I is the, what we have already know, that I is the, here this is the I, that is N L I, I is the I value, this is I value, and just substituting the I value in mu naught into I, mu, that is here L get cancelled here, okay, this L and L get this here L and L get cancelled, remaining B is equal to mu naught into N I. What is the I value here? This is the I value, this is the I, this I is, this I is this I, current passing through the coil, N L I. Okay, this is the magnetic field, B is equal to mu naught into N I. N is the number of turns inside the coil and I is the current, how much current is passing through. That is, the magnetic field is always depend upon the applied current, how much current is applying, that much of magnetic field will be producing. Okay, so that magnetic field is depends on current and number of turns, not in the length, not in the length, just keep in your mind. Okay, this is called derivation of the magnetic field due to solenoid. Okay, hope you understand this one. I will repeat once again some definition here. What do you mean by solenoid? Solenoid is a spring type conductor coil or a cylindrical coil of wire acting as a magnet. A cylindrical coil of wire acting as a magnet when carrying electric current. When carrying electric current, that is called solenoid. Okay, this is very important concept. Or if you go through this video, if you are finding any doubt, please get back to me. Okay, thank you.